With me is Dr. Pradeep Jain. Dr. Pradeep Jain practices at Kashi Ganga Nursing Home at Varanasi. Dr. Pradeep was recently awarded State of the Art Clinic Foot Clinic Award in June 18 from Professor Andrew Bolton, the current IDF President. Sir, congratulations for this award.
Thank you.
And welcome to the RSSDI TV studio, sir. We would like to have some insights from you regarding management of diabetic foot ulcers. Sir, how common is diabetic foot ulcer in your clinical practice?
As such, diabetic foot ulcer is quite common. We are getting about 2 to 3 patients in regular OPD cases. And some of them are having frank and foot ulcers. But most of the patients are at the primary stage of the foot ulcers. So it is important so that we can educate the people or educate the persons or educate the attendants of the diabetic patients that it can be prevented, because prevention is much more easier, cost effective and important for diabetic patients as compared to the treatment of diabetic foot ulcers. Because once this diabetic foot happens, then it is much more economically burden, much heavier economically burden to the patient and the family. And the risk of amputation and risk of other comorbid conditions like CKD or MI or other conditions, it is always going to happen in such patients.
So what are your recommendations for patients so that they can do diabetic foot ulcer prevention?
Every doctor, every physician, he should touch the patient's feet while examining the patient. Because in our Hindu mythology, or again, there's a tradition of touching the feet. And if a doctor or a consultant physician in every visit of the patient, if he touches the feet or of the patient, or if he touching the feet means regularly examining the feet, then he can prevent maximum number of diabetic foot ulcers. So basic important thing is every patient should be examined for diabetic foot ulcers or the conditions that are prone to be having the development of diabetic foot ulcers, number one. Number two, right technique of the examining of the foot and right technique of the nail cutting or other conditions like ingrowing toenail and hygienic point of view and other foot cleaning and these callus formation, removing of the callus. These all things should be told to the patients that he should regularly while taking bath examine the foot as he is examining his face regularly. So he should also examine his foot regularly. A simple technique is there, taking a mirror and then examining the feet is always a better thing to avoid diabetic foot ulcers. Second, I used to tell to the patient that walking, no doubt it's a very important and it's a regular tool for the diabetic foot patients to control his diabetes. But I would advise that it is not essential, or it should be avoided in patients having history of diabetic foot ulcers. Or history of having peripheral neuropathy, or history of having ischemic foot. Because once they get, because they are not sensitized to the trauma, and once they get the diabetic foot, the spread of the diabetic foot or the it occurs very rapidly, and so it should be avoided in patients having such histories.
So how important is footwear, the selection of right footwear for the diabetic patients?
Yeah, this is a very good question, because The primary pathology starts from the choosing wrong footwear, because once the callus formation is there and if it is not removed properly and if it is not removed timely, then it is necessary, or it is must that in future months or days or years the patient will certainly have this diabetic foot. So the importance of choosing right footwear, right time to choose the footwear, it is very much important. And if the patient is having already a diabetic foot ulcer, then the offloading of the foot, it should be done in every diabetic patient, so that the amputation can be prevented and the limb can be salvaged properly.
Does posture play an important role in etiology of diabetic foot ulcer?
Yes, certainly, because the whole body weight is transferred to the knee joint or the ankle joint. So if the patient is not standing properly, or the transferring of the weight is not done properly, then the patient is going to suffer from the charcot foot, or having this deformities, foot deformities. And once there is a foot deformity, in coming days or years, the patient is going to have this adaptive foot ulcer. So right posture, right use of footwear, and right examination of the foot, these are the few basic things which are necessary and which must be told to every diabetic patient.
I think you very aptly summarized that the right posture, right selection of footwear, and regular physical examination of the patient, and very, very important is the foot examination of the patients in all the clinic visits, can help us in early diagnosis as well as preventing development of foot ulcers in large number of patients. Any last message, sir, you would like to say to your audience over here?
I used to tell every doctor and every colleague that foot examination is very, very, very must. So keep a practice of touching the feet or examining the feet in every visit. This is my first and last message to all fellow doctors and all colleague doctors. So we can prevent or we can salvage this foot amputation or limb amputation.
Thank you, sir. Thanks a lot for joining RSSDI TV today here. And thanks a lot, sir.
Thank you.